Hey, what's going on, everyone? Greg here, and the entire Apple Silicon roadmap just leaked, and... Wait, Luke Miani already did a video on it? Ah, Luke! He's always one step ahead of me! Curse you, Luke! Curse you! Well, at least I'm still ahead of Renee, so it's not that bad. Anyway, yes, it's true. There's a big report coming out from Mark Gurman detailing what's next for Apple's Mac lineup and some timeframes for their 2-year transition, with some of those computers maybe just barely hitting this roadmap goal. So for this video, let's talk about when you can really expect those fancy new M1X MacBook Pros, 30-inch iMac, M1X Mac Mini, a half-size Mac Pro, and maybe a few surprises along the way. Also, before we get into this video, I just want to make a quick plug. You know, this is my birthday week, August 6th, so if you aren't subscribed already, get subscribed to the channel. Very close to 200,000. And also, follow me on Twitter. I'm actually trying to hit 10,000 Twitter followers, so even more than the subscription to this channel. If you have a Twitter account, give me a follow on Twitter, because there's some features I want to unlock when you get to 10,000 followers. And if you did it, consider a birthday gift, and I would be very thankful. But anyway, let's get back into the video. Now, to clarify something here, Apple has set a 2-year goal of fully transitioning the entire Mac lineup to their own custom Apple Silicon, meaning by the end of 2 years, every single Mac, from the Mac Mini to the Mac Pro, should be running on some version of Apple Silicon. However, there are some disagreements as to when this timeline officially started. I, for one, think it started at WWDC 2020, where Apple originally announced this transition with their A12X Mac Mini developer kit, while people like Mark Gurman believe that the countdown timer for this transition actually started with the release of the first M1 Macs back in November. So, a little disagreement here between me and Gurman, but let me know in the comments below, when do you think the 2-year transition timer officially begins, and do you agree with me or Mark Gurman? So, first off, yes, M1X MacBook Pros, you have all been waiting so patiently, okay, you've been waiting impatiently for them, but the true level Pro next generation MacBook Pros are coming from Apple. And based on this Apple Silicon roadmap report, we won't have to wait too much longer, because these Macs will be the next Apple Silicon Macs to be released, with Gurman saying that the M1X MacBook Pros are still on track to be released in the coming months. Now, for a 1-minute refresher here, we are expecting a redesign of the MacBook Pro with smaller bezels for a new 14-inch model that will replace the existing 13-inch 4-port model, a mini LED display with greater contrast ratios and screen brightness for HDR videos, more ports on these machines, with current rumors saying 3 Thunderbolt ports, 1 HDMI port, 1 SD card slot, and a MagSafe charging connector. And if I had to put my own guesses on this, I would say that we would also see an Ethernet port included in the power brick like we just recently got with the M1 iMac. I think bringing that to the pro-level MacBooks just makes a lot of sense, and if they're bringing back MagSafe, and we know they can do a magnetic charger with data connections on the iMac, it would be a great feature. Of course, most of you already know this next part, and that is that the biggest upgrade to this MacBook Pro will of course be the new M1X chip, with rumors of a 10-core CPU design with 8 high-performance cores and 2 energy-efficient cores. This MacBook Pro might be one of the most powerful Macs ever made, and it will also feature an untested 16 and maybe up to an optional 32-core GPU that could provide a huge jump up in graphics capabilities, and that would mean that maybe this Apple Silicon might even rival dedicated GPUs, and if rumors turn out anywhere close to true, these could be pretty powerful. Now, this video is mostly focusing on the timeline releases for these products, so with that in mind, Gurman seems pretty confident that both the 14 and 16-inch MacBook Pro with the M1X chip will be released in the coming months and before the end of 2021. Now, while the closest possible event for Apple is probably just 1 month away with Apple's usual September event, I personally don't think we will see the new M1X MacBook Pro announced at this particular event. Apple will probably have their plates full for that event, wanting to mainly focus on the release of the new iPhone 13, Apple Watch Series 7, and also some other updates like the new redesign for the iPad mini and maybe a refresh to the budget iPad. However, don't worry, because even if Apple doesn't show off the M1X MacBook Pro at this September event, they should be following up with another virtual event either next month in October or at the latest a last minute event in November to get these products announced before the end of this year. Now, another Mac I was expecting to launch at this event was the M1X Mac Mini. It would parallel the first Apple M1 announcement, where the first computers they showed off were two laptops, the M1 MacBook Air and M1 MacBook Pro, and then one desktop computer, the M1 Mac Mini. I thought Apple would take a similar strategy here and introduce us to the 14 and 16 inch MacBook Pros, and then for people who need a desktop option with a plethora of ports, there would be the M1X Mac Mini. Now, the wording here from Gurman is strange, because he says that the new Mac Mini will come soon after that, as in soon after the release of the M1X MacBook Pros. Now, I think it makes total sense for Apple to announce the M1X MacBook Pros and M1X Mac Mini right alongside each other, so there's an M1X option for laptop users and desktop users. And the Mac Mini doesn't seem like a hard computer to manufacture, so it would be pretty easy to take that M1X chip and just stick it into a Mac Mini and call it a day. But the wording of soon after implies that it won't be announced at the same event. But then Gurman specifically says that the M1X iMac is going to come out in 2022. So maybe if this M1X Mac Mini isn't announced alongside the MacBook Pros at that event, it could possibly be announced sometime before the end of this year in like a press release. But personally, I just think it's still going to be announced at the same event, and I think we will see M1X MacBook Pros and Mac Mini announced alongside each other. And yes, you didn't mishear me. Gurman provided a release date for the M1X 30-inch iMac redesign, and just like I have been saying in a few of my past videos on this subject, we are not expecting the M1X iMac to be announced by the end of this year, and it's likely that the M1X iMac will follow a very similar development cycle and release date to the M1 iMac and be announced months later, even though it's going to have the same M1X chip as those laptops. And it's possible we could see this M1X 30-inch iMac announced at Apple Spring event for 2022, just like the M1 iMac was. Now, for this M1X iMac, it seems like it's going to be, you know, the pro-level iMac, so it could have the same design as the M1 iMac with more pro colors and black bezels, or maybe its own unique design. Obviously, it will still use the same M1X chip as the MacBook Pros, no surprise there, but it could still be a really compelling desktop option if Apple uses the mini LED display technology in a big 30-inch display. We could be looking at one of the best monitors on the market, coupled together with the amazing power of this theoretical M1X chip. Now, another surprise thrown in the mix here is the release of an update to the MacBook Air with an M2 chip in it, which could happen surprisingly around the same time as this M1X iMac update. And this would be the first true generational chip jump for Apple's Mac processors. And the new M2 MacBook Air will probably be stronger in single core performance than even the new M1X MacBook Pros, but it will still be severely weaker in multi-core CPU and in GPU performance. However, this Air could bring an entirely new redesign that brings it in line with the consumer-level M1 iMac and be even lighter and thinner, with reduced bezels while still keeping the 13-inch display size to make it more portable. And John Prosser, who correctly told us first about the iMacs getting a colorful redesign, says that these new M2 MacBook Airs would receive the same treatment and we could see them in multiple color options. Finally, there's the big boy. Or the half-size boy. Or the small boy? The half-size Mac Pro. Now, this will likely be the final Mac to get transitioned over to Apple Silicon, and that makes sense. It's the most powerful Mac out there, and obviously Apple is going to have to save or create its strongest chipset just for that specific machine. Interestingly enough, we should still see some updates to the Intel Mac Pro before we get an Apple Silicon Mac Pro. And just the other day, Apple actually added some new AMD GPU options for the Intel Mac Pro. And Mark Gurman even says that there will be some additional changes coming later with new Intel Ice Lake Xeon CPU options. So there will be two different Mac Pro options, at least for a short time being. And this new Apple Silicon Mac Pro will apparently be half the size of the current Mac Pro and feature a Frankenstein M1X chip combination where it takes multiple M1X chips to make a 20 and 40 core CPU configuration and possibly as much as 128 GPU cores in the highest end model. However, the Apple Silicon Mac Pro is still coming by the end of this 2-year transition, and it might just barely make it over that finish line, with Gurman expecting this to be announced all the way at the end of 2022. If I had to guess, I bet Apple will meet their WWDC 2-year transition by pre-announcing the Apple Silicon Mac Pro. However, Gurman may also partially be right too, because I would expect only a preview of the Mac Pro at WWDC 2022, and we probably won't be able to order this high-end Apple Silicon Mac Pro until the end of the year in November or December of 2022. That would be very, very sneaky, Apple. Like, yeah, you would technically meet your 2-year transition goal, but with like an asterisk next to it. All right, everyone, but that is basically the updated Apple Silicon roadmap for the rest of this 2-year transition. And I am just so excited to see what these machines are actually like, because I am still amazed by the performance of the M1 machines, and I hope I am blown away by the performance in the next generation Macs as well. But let me know, are you excited for these new Macs? What do you think of the current timeline? And do you think Apple will hit their 2-year transition goal? As always, if you like this video, be sure to give me a like. If you want to see more from the channel, make sure you're subscribed. And as always, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all in the next video. Take care, everyone.